Hi, I'm Susan Clapton. I've just arrived here at Brussels Airport in Belgium. I'm here to learn more about Etex, a global building material manufacturer and pioneer in lightweight construction. Their headquarters, a mere 5 minutes walk from here. According to the 2021 annual report, Etex performed strongly, and not only where financial results are concerned. Their focus on meeting the needs of the world seems to have given the company a proper direction in other areas as well. Employee engagement, commercial excellence, operational performance, and sustainability. I want to find out, why did customers put their trust in Etex's commercial brands and solutions in this period of global uncertainties? And how did Etex meet those needs of local markets and communities across the globe to create value? Let's investigate the major drivers of this success. I have an appointment at Etex headquarters with Bernard Delvaux, the company's brand new CEO. See you there. Hi, Bernard.
Hello.
Now, Etex's performance was quite impressive in 2021. May I call you a proud CEO?
Yes, absolutely. I think it was a very impressive result in 2021. I want to start by thanking all the teammates of Etex who have done a great job in 2021. You know, I just joined the company in September. I'm the new CEO since January, so I'm completely new in this business and this company. But I discover a company which is great in terms of drive, energy, and teamwork.
And what is Etex's secret, if I could call it that?
You know, we have one purpose, which is inspiring ways of living. And this is a kind of guideline for everything we do. And this helps us translate it into a very clear strategic roadmap. Mm. And then we deliver.
And I understand that over the last 4 years, Etex has completely shifted its portfolio of activities.
Yes, we decided to focus on lightweight and sustainable building materials. So at the same time, we decided to exit what was not lightweight construction materials. And we invested more and more in the classical product like plasterboard, fiber cement, and pacifier protection. At the same time, we invested also in new ways, which was the prefab and industrial type of buildings, modules, 2D panels, or 3D modules.
And I understand that Etex has been quite active regarding acquisitions. Is that also true?
This is true. 2021 was an important year. We acquired a very important Australian player in plasterboard, one of the top players in Australia. We invested also by acquiring four companies in new ways. So a very important year for us, confirming the strategic direction.
And Etex has added a fifth technology, insulation, is that right?
Yes, true. We are in the process of closing the acquisition of Ursa, which is one of the top three players in insulation in Europe. And this is for us now the fifth leg, the fifth portfolio of product, which is very complementary to what we do. And all this is supported by four priorities, which are people, commercial excellence, operational excellence, and then the fourth pillar, which is very important today, is sustainability and innovation.
Bernard, thank you so much for your time. The financial results of 2021 were outstanding for Etex. Not only was it a record year, but there has been a solid track record of the results getting better every single year since 2018. Now, how can that be, given that it was such a challenging year? To find out more, I'm on my way to speak with Muriel de France, Head of Business Partnering for Operations. Ah, and here she is. Hi, Muriel. Thanks so much for meeting with me.
My pleasure.
Now, it's clear that Etex performed very well last year, but just how well exactly? Could you tell us more?
Sure. 2021 was a year of record performance at Etex on almost all level. Our revenue increased by almost 19% compared to 2020. Our EBITDA reached a very high level in absolute value. Our net recurring profit improved by 24%, another record. And our free cash flow generation reached new heights. So really, from a financials perspective, 2021 was a fantastic year.
Mm. Now that's absolutely impressive. And how can you explain this given the fact that you faced many challenges last year?
Well, it's true that revenue and EBITDA started to slow down from September. due to scarcity of raw material and supply challenges, which led to unprecedented inflation and cost increases. Mm. But our supply chain and manufacturing team were able to face those challenges, backed by high demand and very dynamic markets. Mm. The renovation market and the home surge repair really led to a very high peak in margins. We were also able to contain our overheads and we benefited from prior year cost containing actions.
And what's Etex's outlook for 2022?
So we expect demand to remain very strong in the first half of the year. The evolution in the second half is a bit more difficult to evaluate at this stage. Raw material and energy cost increases, the war in Ukraine, potential disruption linked to new variant of COVID-19. These are all factors of uncertainty and therefore of instability. Our division remain proactive in managing their cost to price performance, which is key in today's high inflation environment. Mm.
Thank you so much for your time, Muriel.
You're welcome.
We've just heard about the challenges the supply chain has faced. Now, I want to know more about how Etex has succeeded in organizing its material supply and in getting its products to the customers all across the globe on time. To answer this, I'm on my way now to one of the Etex plants in Belgium to meet with Isabel Belsor, Global Head of Supply Chain. Wow, what an impressive warehouse. Isabel, I have heard that supply chain has been under a lot of pressure since the last year. Is that correct?
That's correct. That's the least you can say. 2021 has been a very difficult year for supply chain globally in many ways, not just for our sector or for Etex. Booming demand after COVID-related restrictions were lifted has led to supply shortages and cost increases. On top of that, there has been other events that have contributed to make the situation even more complex, such as the Suez Canal, port congestions, shortages of drivers, warehouses, and increases in freight cost.
And how did you tackle those very difficult challenges?
A strong collaboration has been established with our colleagues from purchasing, our manufacturing sites, all supported as well by IT systems so the information can flow. We have a new scheduling system called DDMRP. We've also had to enhance our sales and operations planning process, which has been instrumental. So together, the teams have prioritized deliveries and resources in order to keep our factories running and ship to our customers. Mm.
And tell me, what are you most proud of?
People. Mm. Teammates have joined forces together to find solutions to the topics I've just mentioned, the shortages, the container crisis, and so on. And really, we have seen all this teamwork paying off, and we've all been operating as one Etex to protect our customers. We still need to be vigilant. Supply prices are still raising, and also volatility has become the new norm. Therefore, there's no room for complacency in supply chain.
Isabel, thank you so much for your time. At Etex, employee engagement is outstanding. Last year, they recorded an 86% sustainable engagement rate across the company. That's 6% above sector peers. I'm on my way to meet with Malcolm Stamper, Corporate Brand Coordinator, to speak about one of the initiatives to boost well-being and connect teammates. Malcolm's plane should be arriving for London any minute now. Hi, Malcolm. Thanks for joining me. Now, I've heard that the company nurtures both the mental and physical well-being of all teammates worldwide through initiatives like the Etex Challenge. Could you tell me more?
Yes, it is. It's been a great time. We recognize that actually having healthier teammates makes us a stronger global company. So we partnered up with an external provider to provide this unique challenge, something that encouraged teammates to do a physical activity every single day. So to start with, we gave everybody an Etex sports shirt, made from recycled plastic, so they could wear the Etex colours with pride. They then logged their activities, which included all sports and different abilities, via a central app, and then we provided a leaderboard. Give that a little bit of healthy competition between different teammates in different countries.
And how did that turn out?
It turned out really well. Over 3,000 teammates joined the challenge, boosting their physical and mental well-being. It really showed the core value we have at Etex of connect and care. And teammates shared pictures and videos of themselves taking part in the challenge, which was especially important during COVID. It really increased team spirit during the company during that time.
And what else motivated teammates to take part?
So we really wanted to bring our purpose, inspiring ways of living alive, during this challenge. So the teammates also raised money for charity. Together they raised over 17,000 euros for our NGO partner Habitat for Humanity. Mm-hmm. And the money's going to empower women in Zambia with land access, which in turn gives economic empowerment. We couldn't have done this without our local site activators at us around the world. They motivated our teammates to come and join and take part in the challenge. They did an absolutely outstanding job and we're super proud of them.
Malcolm, that is truly inspiring. Thank you so much for your time. I'll let you get on to your next flight. Sustainability is one of the company's four strategic drivers. The company's sustainability agenda includes several priorities: health, safety and well-being, decarbonization, circularity, diversity and inclusion, and education. Today, I want to learn more about Etex's community engagement. Across the world, Etex initiates or supports community projects. We found a great example of this in the Western Cape province of South Africa. I called into a local teammate to tell us more about it. Siyabu Siso, the floor is yours.
Hi, Susan. Thank you. In South Africa, with a population of 60 million, almost 7 million of those people live in informal settlements where the living conditions can be so harsh. 40% have no direct access to drinking water or decent sanitation. Etex South Africa has partnered with a local non-profit organization called Ikhayalami to help and improve the situation. Initially, Etex South Africa provided building materials and financial contributions to help set up the early childhood development centers. But our partnership has evolved the past 2 years. And now we provide full solutions that meet local needs identified by Ikhayalami. That will be lightweight and modular building solutions, which are ideal here as they offer cost-effective and are durable. We supported the revamping of these community daycare centers, which house the children between the ages of 6 months to 6 years old. For example, we ensured that there's better daylight autonomy, improved acoustics, and energy saving. Our teammates at Etex have also helped in terms of design, plan, and execute these three building models, which are called prototypes, which are ideal for cottages, playhouses, classroom, and clinics, and literally also for residential houses. And these buildings are pre-engineered and arrive on site on ready assembled packs like a Meccano set. And we literally train community members to assemble these buildings just to ensure the transfer of skills.
It's great to see how the daily efforts of Etex teammates contributes to supporting local communities all over the world. Etex does everything to deliver and make its customers happier, that's clear. In 2021, Etex took a major digital step to make the lives of its customers better and easier. I'm going to have a brief chat with Sema Muslu, customer advisor based in Trossac, France, to hear more about it. Hi, Sema. Sema, last year, My Etex, an online portal for direct customers, was introduced. What's been their feedback?
We got many enthusiastic reactions. You know, reliability and transparency are crucial for our customers to keep their customers loyal and happy. And thanks to MyEtex, we make it easier for them to do business with us as they have an easy and direct access to all information related to orders, deliveries, and much more in one central location for all Etex commercial brands.
So MyEtex has become a popular tool.
We see customers using it almost every day. Via MyEtex, they can track and trace their trucks with their deliveries. They can download invoices and communicate directly with customer service and order process. We also run localized campaign and provide how-to videos and actively ask their feedback. They share with us that my Etex is much more complete than the competitors' platforms.
Great. So where is the portal available and what's next?
My Etex is live in 10 countries with more countries and added options in the pipeline. We are actively working with our customers and gathering their feedbacks to understand their needs and provide an enriching experience. You know, my Etex is a key contribution to truly partner with our customers, supporting them in their day-to-day activities.
Thank you so much, Sema. Bye-bye. Well, that's it for today. My conclusion? Etex is taking its purpose of inspiring ways of living to heart and executing its strategy meticulously. Do you want to learn more about the way that Etex meets the needs of the world and how that has led to outstanding achievements this last year? Take a deep dive into the 2021 annual report by clicking on the link below. Thanks so much for watching. Bye-bye.